ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय Diksha ceremony. Diksha means the process, beginning the process of, well, Diksha, it means initiation. And so with Diksha, it means taking away sinful reactions and giving transcendental knowledge. So we should understand that these things don't happen immediately. But if you practice the process of devotional service, regularly hearing and chanting, then that will happen. We have to hear through the disciplic succession. And we have to follow the principles, the different rules and regulations which are given to us by the Acharyas. And so today we are having the ceremony of Diksha, bringing people into that process of devotion.
So, we will give you Diksha 启迪, 就是将人们带入这个奉献服务的程序当中.
And the Diksha connects us to the disciplic succession.
Diksha 将我们与使徒传系连接在一起.
There are four bona fide disciplic successions.
有四个正宗的使徒传承.
Means four lines of Vaishnava teachings.
也就是说这个Vaishnava的教导有四条传承。
All the Vaishnava teachers explain that the living entity is not equal to the Supreme Lord, but he is a servant of the Supreme Lord.
所有的Vaishnava的老师都教导这个生物体,个体生物,他们不能等同于至尊主,他们是主的仆人。
There are other disciplic successions which are not Vaishnava. Just like the line coming through Shankaracharya. So Shankaracharya, his teaching is that the living entity and the Lord can be equal.
桑卡查雅他教导的是个体生物能够与至尊主平等。
They're explaining, usually the followers of Shankaracharya explain the Advaita philosophy. Advaita, oneness, that there's no difference between the Lord and the living entities. So this is not accepted in the Vaishnava line. In the Vaishnava teaching, the Lord is distinguished between the living entities. And this is supported with a lot of evidence from the scriptures.
而这一点呢，在经典当中有很多的证据可以证明。
And these scriptures are both in the Shruti and in the Smriti.
经典有Shruti也有Smriti.
The Shruti means the four Vedas.
Shruti指的是四部伟达经。
So in the four Vedas, the Vedic knowledge, there are Upanishads which are part of the Vedas.
在四部伟达经当中，有那个乌帕尼萨德，它是伟达经当中的一部分。
And in the Upanishads, it explains that there's one supreme Lord and all others are his servants.
在乌帕尼沙德当中说到，只有一位至尊主，其他的生物体都是他的仆人。
Amongst all eternal beings, there's one supreme eternal being.
在所有永恒的生物当中，有一位至尊永恒的灵魂。
And amongst all conscious living entities, there's one supreme conscious living entity.
在所有有知觉的生物体当中，有只有一位是至尊的有知觉的生物体。
And that one supreme Lord.Is maintaining and providing the needs for all the other living entities.
那一位至尊的，有知觉的生物体呢，它维系着所有其他的生物体，并且为他们提供所需要的。
So this is clearly stated in the Vedas.
所以这一点在《维达经》中有清楚的描述。
And it's also supported with a lot of evidence.In the Bhagavad Gita and in the Srimad Bhagavatam.
而且在《薄伽梵歌》以及《圣典薄伽瓦坛》当中也有非常多的证据。
Of course, Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam are not Shruti, but they are Smriti.
当然了，《薄伽梵歌》和《圣典薄伽瓦坛》并不属于 Shruti 的范畴，它们是属于 Smriti。
The devotional service is performed.According to the teachings of both the Shruti and the Smriti.
所以呢，这个奉献服务是由Shruti和 Shruti 两者的指导下进行的。
There are different sections of Vedic knowledge.
韦达知识当中有不同的部分。
So we explained that our scriptures say Shruti, Smriti, Puranadi, Pancharatriki Vidimbinam.Aikantiki Harer Bhaktir Bhutpata Yaiva Kaupate. The devotional service should be performed according to both the Shruti and the Smriti, and then also the Puranas and the Itihasas.
So, this is from the 经典当中的一个师姐，只能说到我们奉献服务呢，应该根据 Shruti, Smriti, Purana, 以及 Itihasa
的那个经典所进行。So there are different. There are different these different divisions of the Vedic scriptures, and we follow all of these different scriptures.
所有这些都是韦达知识当中不同的。部分，但是呢，我们要遵循所有的这些部分当中的知识。
So I was explaining there are four Vaishnava lines of succession.
我们刚才提到有四条使徒传系。
One is coming from Lakshmi.
其中一条来自于 Lakshmi, 幸运女神。
That is known as the Ramanuja line or the line of the Sri Vaishnavas.
那是来自于拉玛努贾查亚的传系，也被称为睡夏玛那亚。
Ramanuja Acharya appeared in this world about 1,000 years ago.
拉玛努贾查亚大概是一千多年前显现在这个世界的。
And then there's also the line coming from Nimbarka Acharya.
还有一条传系来自于 Nimbarka Acharya.
And that line comes from the four Kumaras.
那一条传系来自于四姑妈尔。
And they are also devotees of Radha and Krishna.
他们也是 Radha 和 Krishna 的奉献者。
Usually the Sri Vaishnavas, they like to worship more Lakshmi and Narayan.
通常 Sri Sampradaya 的人呢，更倾向于崇拜 Lakshmi 和 Narayan.
They're also meant to worship Lord Ramachandra.
他们也会崇拜 Ramachandra.
So Nimbarkas, they worship also Radha and Krishna.
Nimbarka Acharya 的传系呢，也崇拜 Radha 和 Krishna.
And if you go to Varsana, you'll see there's a temple there of the Nimbarka Acharya people.
如果你们去 Varsana 的话，你们就会看到那里有一个 Nimbarka Acharya 传系当中的一个庙宇。
Then there's another line coming from Lord Shiva.
另外一条传记呢，来自于主Shiva。
Lord Shiva is also a great Vaishnava.
主Shiva也是一位伟大的 Vaishnava.
And we also offer our respects to all of these great Vaishnavas.
我们也会向所有这些伟大的 Vaishnava 致以我们的敬意。
We also respect the four Kumaras and Mother Lakshmi and Lord Shiva.
我们也会尊敬是库玛拉，库玛拉也会尊敬 Lakshmi 女神，也会尊敬主Shiva。
They are all blessed with transcendental knowledge.
他们都受到了这个超然知识的祝福。
Sometimes in our own life, some devotees are very attached to worship Lord Shiva.
有的时候在我们传记当中呢，有一些人非常依附崇拜主Shiva。
But they worship Lord Shiva as a devotee. They don't worship him as the Supreme Lord.
但是呢，他们将主Shiva作为一名奉献者崇拜，而不是将他作为至尊主崇拜。
So Lord Shiva, Lakshmi, the four Kumaras. They're all great devotees.
所以主Shiva、Lakshmi还有Shri Kumar，他们都是伟大的奉献者。
Our line is coming from Lord Brahma.
我们的传世是来自于主Brahma。
Lord Brahma is also a great devotee.
主Brahma也是一位伟大的奉献者。
In a little while, we will recite the Brahma Samhita.
等一会呢，我们会念诵这个Brahma Samhita。
Maybe you know some of the prayers. It always, each sloka ends with Govindam Adi Purusham Tamaham Vajami. We worship Govinda, the Supreme Lord. So Lord Brahma knows he is not supreme.
主Brahma知道他不是至尊。
And he also worships Govinda.
所以他也崇拜主Govinda。
So our line of the cyclic succession is coming from Lord Brahma.
我们的始祖传世是来自主Brahma。
And it comes through Madhva Acharya.
这个是通过 Madhva Acharya 传承下来的。
Madhva Acharya also appeared in this world about 1,000 years ago.
Madhva Acharya, 也是大约1000年前显现在这个世界.
His temple was established in a place called Udupi, which is in Karnataka.
他的这个庙呢，在Udupi那个地方，那个地方叫Karnataka.
It's on the coast of India.
它是在那个印度的一个海岸边上。
Madhvacharya, he was able to establish a beautiful deity of Lord Krishna.
Madhvacharya 在那里呢，就是安放了一个非常美丽的主 Krishna 的神像。 And
it said that deity of Krishna was worshipped by Rukmini, Lord Krishna's wife.
据说那个神像是曾经由 Rukmini, 也就是 Krishna 的妻子崇拜过的。
So it's a very ancient temple. It still is there today. You can go and visit Udupi.
所以那是一个非常古老的庙宇，就是到现在还存在在那里。你们可以去拜访那里。
Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took initiation in the line coming from Brahma through Madhvacharya.
所以主Chaitanya是从 Madhvacharya 的这个 Brahma 传记当中接受的启迪。
So the Lord Chaitanya's line is called Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya.
所以主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的传记叫做
Brahma
Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya.
So you can see the line of transcendental knowledge is coming from Lord Brahma. And Lord Brahma, he got the knowledge directly from Lord Krishna.
Brahma, 他是直接从主 Krishna 本人那里接受了超然的知识。
So the knowledge which we are giving to people is authorized, it's coming from scriptures.
所以我们给予人们的知识呢是得到授权的，它是来自于经典的。
We're not saying that, oh, we made up this knowledge. We're not saying this is our knowledge, but it is knowledge which is passed down from the beginning of time.
我们并不是说这个知识是我们自己编造的，而是这个知识它是从创造之初，就是传递下来的。
And the chanting of the holy names is also coming from the Lord Himself.
而这个对圣名的唱诵也是来自于主本人。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu established the importance of the chanting of the holy name as the process to deliver us in this age.
所以主查泰马哈帕夫他确立了这个在这个年代唱诵圣名的重要性，来拯救我们这个年代堕落的人。
This is the Kali Yuga.
这是卡利年代。
So in the Kali Yuga.We have a short life.
在康利年代，我们的寿命都很短。
Other ages, people lived much longer.
在其他的年代的时候，人们的寿命要长得多。
But in the Kali Yuga, if you live even to be 100, you're very, very old.
但是在卡利年代，即便是你只活了100年，你都被认为是非常非常年老的。
And we know most people don't manage to live so long.
但是我们知道大部分的人都不会活得那么久。
But in other ages, people live much longer.
但是在其他的年代里，人们的寿命要长很多。
In the Satya Yuga, people live 100,000 years.
在萨迦年代，人们的寿命是100,000年。
Then in the Treta Yuga, people live 10,000 years.
在三千年代人们的寿命是100,000年，然后在春法年代人们的寿命是100,000年。
And the previous yuga was Dwapara Yuga, and people were living 1,000 years.
在上一个年代 Dwapara 年代的时候，人们的寿命是1,000年。
But now Kali Yuga, hardly we can live 100 years.
但是在卡利年代，人们只能活100年。
70 years is usually.
通常是70年。
So we have a short life.
所以我们的寿命很短。
And we're also very unfortunate.
我们也非常的不幸。
We're very lazy.
非常懒惰。
We don't like to work hard.
我们不想努力的工作。
We like to take life easy.
我们想过一种舒适休闲的生活。
We like to relax a lot.
我们想就是总是放松的状态。
And so Kali Yuga people we're very unqualified.
所以在卡利年代的人们是非常不具备资格的。
But there's one good thing about Kali Yuga.
但是呢，在卡利年代有一件好的事情。
And that is simply by chanting the holy name.We can get all success.
那就是通过唱诵圣名，我们能够取得所有的成功。
So, the process of initiation is to make us vow to regularly chant the holy name.
所以启迪的程序就是让我们来发下这个誓言，有规律的念诵圣名。
That we make at the time of initiation.We make a vow to regularly chant Hare Krishna mantra.
在启迪的时候呢，我们发现誓言要有规律的念诵 Hare Krishna mantra.
And we're going to give each of the devotees who are being initiated, we'll give them some beads to chant.
每一个接受启迪的奉献者，他们都会得到一串念珠。
And I chant on them. I've chanted on each of the beads myself.
我自己呢，在这些念珠上面都念诵过。
And I will give one set of beads to each of the devotees.
然后我会把这些念珠给到要接受启迪的每一位奉献者。
And we want them to regularly chant, and we encourage the devotees that you should chant a minimum of 16 rounds a day.
所以我希望他们能够有规律的念诵，我们是要求奉献者们每天至少念诵16圈。
Which means it's going to take about 2 hours time to chant.
那意味着我们每天要花2个小时的时间念诵。
Now if you say you can chant 16 rounds in 1 hour, then you will have to chant 32 rounds every day.
那如果你觉得, 你一个小时就可以念16圈的话，那么你每天就念32圈。
Because we want you to spend at least 2 hours chanting the holy name.
因为我们希望你们每天至少要花2个小时的时间来念诵圣名。
We want you to fix your mind on the holy name.
我们希望你们能够把心意专注在圣名当中。
Because it's very important to control the mind.
要控制心意是非常重要的。
By the mind, we can be elevated, and by the mind, we can be degraded.
心也能够使我们得到提升，也可以使我们堕落。
So the mind can be the friend, but the mind can also be an enemy.
所以心意可以变成朋友，也可以变成敌人。
We have to control the mind very carefully.
我们要非常小心地来控制我们的心意。
And we are very fortunate that we've been given this Maha Mantra to chant.
我们非常的幸运，因为我们得到了这个Maha Mantra的念诵。
There are many other mantras, of course.
当然了，还有其他很多的mantra.
But they don't have the same power as the holy name.
但是其他的那些mantra并不具备和圣名一样的力量。
Just like some people may like to chant Vishnu Sahasranam.
比方说，有的人唱诵那个Vishnu Sahasra Stotram，means
1,000 names of Vishnu.
也就是主Vishnu的1,000个名字。But
Lord Shiva tells us that the Vishnu Sahasranam is equal to one chanting the holy name of Lord Rama.
但是主希瓦说呢，这个。 Vishnu Sahasra Stotra, 也就是Vishnu的1,000个名字, 只需要唱一遍主 Rama的名字, 就可以获得同样的效果。
Stated, Rame Rame Namo Rame Sahasra Nama Bistuyam Shri Rama Nama Varanini. Lord Shiva said to his wife, don't chant all the 1,000 names of Vishnu, just chant Lord Rama's name.
对他的妻子说道，你不需要唱诵1,000遍那个Vishnu的名字，你只需要唱诵主Rama的名字。
And then it's also said in the scriptures that 3 names of Lord Rama is equal to 1 name of Krishna.
经典里面也说到呢，一遍 Krishna的名字等同于。
There's no mention of chanting any other names than Vishnu, Rama, and Krishna. We don't chant any other names. We don't chant the names of the devas. We only chant the names of the Supreme Lord. That means the name of Lord Krishna, Lord Vishnu, Lord Rama.
那意味着就是我们只唱诵主 Krishna, 主 Vishnu 和主 Rama 的名字。
You can chant these names.
你们可以唱诵这些名字。
But if you chant names of other devas, they will not be very good.
但是如果你们唱诵其他半神人的名字的话，那就不会很好。
You will not get the real benefit of chanting.
你们不会得到这个唱诵的真正的好处。
So the chanting of the holy name, the Maha Mantra, is given to us by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu for everyone to chant.
所以这个对圣名的唱诵，对这个 Hare Krishna Mantra 的唱诵，是由主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 给予我们的，所以每个人都应该唱诵。
Before Lord Chaitanya, the chanting of the holy name was only done in the temple.
在主 Chaitanya 之前，这个对圣名的唱诵只能够在庙宇当中进行。But
Lord Chaitanya brought the chanting of the holy name out of the temple.
但是主才参加把对圣灵的唱颂从庙宇里面带了出来。
And he gave the holy name to everyone.
他把圣名给予了每一个人。
Everyone can chant.
是每一个人都可以唱颂。
You don't have to be initiated to chant.
你甚至不需要接受启迪都可以唱颂。
But if you want to progress in spiritual life, then initiation is important.
但是如果你想在灵性生活当中取得进步的话，那么启迪是很重要的。
If we are serious about getting out from the material world, then we have to take the help of the spiritual teachers.
那如果我们真正的想要从物质世界里摆脱出来的话，我们是需要灵性导师的帮助的。
Just like Srila Prabhupada wrote so many books.
正如说他帕拉卡编撰了那么多的书籍。
And he wrote the teachings of so many great acharyas.
他也写了很多伟大阿查亚们的这个教导。
So it's very good for us to read Prabhupada's books.
阅读说他帕拉卡的书籍对我们来说是非常有益的。
And sometimes there will be things we don't understand.
有的时候呢，可能有一些事情我们不能够理解。
And when you have things you don't understand, you need help. You need a teacher.
如果你们有些事情不能够理解的话，你们需要一名老师的帮助。
Just like we're worshiping deities here.
比方说我们在这里崇拜神像。
So to worship the deity, you should be initiated.
为了能够崇拜神像，你必须接受启迪。
Without initiation.We don't allow people to worship the deity.
如果没有接受启迪的话，我们是不允许人们崇拜神像的。
The initiation means we're made vows to keep our purity.
启迪意味着我们发下誓言，要保持我们的纯粹。
There are four principles of religion.
宗教有四项原则。
Cleanliness.
清洁的原则。
Mercy.
仁慈
austerity,
苦行
and truthfulness,
以及真诚
These four principles are important everywhere in the world.
这四项品质在世界上的任何地方都是非常重要的
Even people may not believe in God, but they will give importance to these principles.
即便一个人也许不相信神但是呢他们也会非常的强调这些思想品质。
They know cleanliness is very important.
他们知道这个洁净是非常重要的。
Cleanliness is external and internal.
洁净分为内在的洁净和外在的洁净。
People, of course, they think about external cleanliness, often they forget about internal cleanliness.
当然了，人们都知道外在的洁净，但是时常忘记内在的洁净。
So to keep ourselves clean, we have to chant the holy name.
所以为了让我们保持纯洁，我们需要唱诵圣名。
And we have to read the books about Krishna.
我们也要阅读有关 Krishna 的书籍。
That will keep us clean and keep us pure.
这样的话，我们就得到净化。
Mercy is important. Mercy is taken away when we kill animals.
仁慈也是重要的品质如果我们去杀戮动物的话就会失去仁慈的品质
We like to be merciful to people and to animals
我们希望我们能够对人以及对动物都展示仁慈
We don't eat people
我们不会吃人
We don't eat animals
我们不会吃动物
But we eat vegetables
我们只吃蔬菜。
But before we eat the vegetables, we offer them to Krishna.
但是呢，在我们吃蔬菜之前，我们会把它供奉给 Krishna.
And in this way, the vegetables also benefit.
以这样的方式，那些蔬菜也得到了受益。
It's an act of mercy.
这就是这个仁慈的行为。
So we are merciful to all different kinds of life.
我们对所有的生命种族都是仁慈的。
Austerity is also important.
苦行这一品质也非常的重要。
Austerity means to give up pride.
苦行意味着放弃骄傲。
So accepting initiation is an austerity.
接受启迪是一项苦行。
We have to submit ourselves.
我们要使自己谦卑臣服。
We approach someone and request them for initiation and for guidance and for teaching.
我们接近一位老师，然后从他那里请求，得到启迪，从他那里接受教导，得到他的指导。
It's an act of humility.
这是一种谦卑的表现。
And to be humble, we have to give up pride.
要变得谦卑的话，我们必须放弃骄傲。
We don't want to be intoxicated.
我们不想就是变得麻醉自我。
Intoxication. People are in the Kali Yuga. People are fond of intoxication.
在卡尼年代，人们有的时候会喜欢麻醉自己。
They drink all kinds of things.
他们喝所有不同的这种东西。
We take all kinds of drugs.
要喝毒品。
And we have everywhere people are drinking coffee and tea, and smoking cigarettes.
人们喝这个咖啡，喝茶，抽烟。
So devotees, one in Krishna consciousness, will not take any intoxication.
所以在 Krishna 知觉当中的奉献者是不会接受任何麻醉品的。
And then also gambling. A devotee will not gamble.
奉献者也不会去赌博。
Because gambling destroys truthfulness.
因为赌博会摧毁诚实的品质。
We gamble in many ways.
我们以很多不同的方式赌博。
We gamble when we waste our valuable time.
当我们在浪费我们宝贵的时间的时候，也是在赌博。
We have to value every moment of time.
我们要珍惜每一刻，每一分钟。
So we have to use the time very carefully.
我们要非常小心的来利用我们的时间。
And if we waste time, then we're gambling with our valuable time.
如果我们就是浪费时间的话，我们就是在跟时间在赌博。
We waste time.Watch so many mundane movies.
我们在这个世俗的电影当中浪费那么多时间。
Nowadays, everybody has a mobile phone.
现在呢，人们都有手机。
And the mobile phone will tell you how many hours every day you've been using the phone.
这个手机会告诉你，你每天在这个手机当中花了多长时间。
You can be shocked.
你会感到非常的震惊的。
How much time we spend to.Answer telephones and talk to people.
就是你们会感到非常的震惊，我们每天有多长时间在用手机与其他人交谈。
And often, we did not talk about anything very important.
而我们所谈论的这些内容呢，都不是很重要的事情。
So this way, we are wasting the valuable time.
所以就像这样，我们浪费了我们宝贵的时间。
And if we waste the time, we don't know what will happen to us in the next life.
如果我们浪费时间的话，我们不能知道我们下一世会发生什么事情。
You don't. Now we have the human body. Next life, we don't know.
现在我们是有人体生命，但是在下一世的时候，谁知道呢？
Just like there was a great king called Bharat.
有一个伟大的国王叫做 Bharat.
And he was very detached from the world. He gave up his kingdom and went to the Himalayas.
他对这个世俗他是非常弃绝的，他放弃了所有的一切，然后去了喜马拉雅山。
But when he was in the Himalayas, he saved the life of a young deer.
但是当他在喜马拉雅山的时候，他救了一头幼鹿的生命。
And he became attached to the animal.
结果他就变得对这个动物非常的依附。
And it happened that he was in the Himalayas and he had an accident. He fell from a cliff. And next life he became a deer.
但是呢，他在喜马拉雅山的时候发生了意外，然后他就在那里去世了。结果下辈子变成了一头鹿。
So he was already very advanced in yoga. He'd given up everything material.
他虽然在这个优雅当中取得了很大的进步，他放弃了所有世俗的一切。
But he became attached to an animal.
但是他变得对一头动物依附。
Next life he became an animal.
结果他下一辈子的时候就变成了一头动物。
He wasted one lifetime.
他浪费了一生的时间。
So we don't want that to happen in our life.
所以我们不希望这种事情发生在我们身上。
We want to get out from this material world quickly.
我们希望很快我们能够出离这个物质世界。
We don't want to keep coming back again.
我们不希望我们会再次回到这里。
So that is the opportunity which is given to us by chanting Hare Krishna mantra.
所以这个机会呢是由通过唱诵 Hare Krishna Maha Mantra 给予了我们。
So we encourage you, because those of you who are taking initiation, you're not living in the temple, you're living at home.
所以我鼓励你们大家，当然了，你们大部分的人并不是住在庙宇里，而是住在自己家里。
So when you're at home, you can also chant.
当你们在自己家里的时候，你们也可以念诵。
Just like we are chanting here, you can be chanting in your home.
正如我们在这里念诵和唱诵一样，你们在家里也可以做这个念诵和唱诵。
We say the family which prays together will stay together.
在一起祈祷的家庭成员呢，会生活在一起。
And the family which chants together.They will dance together.
而一起唱诵的家庭成员呢，他们也会一起跳舞。
And when you dance together, you will advance together.
而当你们一起跳舞的时候，你们就会一起取得进步。
And you can go back to Godhead together.
然后你们大家都会一起回归守神。
So, we encourage you try to apply Krishna consciousness in your home.
所以我鼓励你们大家将 Krishna 知觉运用到你们自己的家中。
Alright. So there are 10 offenses in chanting the holy name.
唱诵圣名有十个冒犯。
I will just quickly say the 10 offenses.
现在我们来快速的说一下这个十个冒犯。
Because when we are chanting, we want to avoid these offenses.
我们在念诵的时候，我们要避免这十项冒犯。
So the first offense is to blaspheme the devotees who dedicated their life to propagating the holy name.
第一项冒犯是冒犯亵渎献出一生传扬主圣名的奉献者。
So this is a very important thing to avoid.
这是需要避免的一个很重要的事情。
We don't want to criticize people.
我们不要批评别人。
Try to see good in devotees.
试着在这个奉献者当中看到好的优点。
So rather than criticize them, try to praise the devotees.
与其这个批评他们，还不如就是赞美他们。
And then the second offense is to consider the names of devas like Lord Shiva and Lord Brahma to be equal to.Are independent of the name of Lord Vishnu.
第二项冒犯是认为主希瓦或 Brahma 的圣名如主威舍的圣名，或不依靠主威舍的圣名。
The third offense is to disobey the order of the spiritual teacher.
第三项冒犯是违背灵性导师的训令。
The spiritual teacher is there, Srila Prabhupada. He's the founder Acharya.
释迦牟尼佛是我们的创办阿查亚。
And all the instructions are there given by him in his books.
他所有的训示都在他的书籍当中给予了我们。
So if you read the books regularly, you will know what are his teachings.
所以如果你们能够经常阅读他的书籍的话，你们就能够了解他的教导是什么。
So it's important try to follow his instructions.
试着去追随他的训示，这是非常重要的。
The fourth offense is to blaspheme the Vedic literature or literature in pursuance of the Vedic version.
第四项冒犯是冒犯亵渎伟达文献或基于伟达逊而写成的文献。
And this means you have to read the books regularly.
这意味着你们要经常有规律的阅读书籍。
If we don't read them regularly, then we are neglecting them. That's an offense.
如果我们没有阅读书籍的话，那意味着我们在忽视他们，这是一项冒犯。
The fifth offense is to consider the glories of chanting Hare Krishna to be imaginary.
第五项冒犯是认为唱诵 Hare Krishna 的荣耀是凭空虚想的。
The sixth offense is to give some interpretation of the holy name.
第六项冒犯是给主的圣名提出世俗的解释。
And the seventh offense is to commit sinful activities on the strength of chanting.
第七项冒犯是借着唱诵主的圣名行恶。
That's a serious offense.
这是一项非常严重的冒犯。
If we think that we can just overcome our sinful reactions by chanting the holy name and go on sinning and then you think well tomorrow I'll chant more and we go on sinning and then chant more then this is offensive chanting
如果我们认为我们通过唱诵圣名可以抵消我们的罪恶的话那这就是一项冒犯比方说你今天做了恶事然后想着第二天哦我要会我可以唱诵圣名来抵消这个罪恶那么这是一项严重的冒犯。
The eighth offense is to consider chanting Hare Krishna to be one of the auspicious ritualistic activities offered in the Vedas as a karmakanda activity.
第八项冒犯是。
第八个冒犯，请知道中文。
认为唱诵 Hare Krishna 是伟达金叶报之不水脱虫的带来吉祥的祭祀仪式及获利性活动。
Yeah. And then the ninth offense to instruct the faithless persons about the glories of the holy name.
第九项冒犯是给全无信念的人宣扬圣名的荣耀。
It's important to create faith in people.
这个要让人们这个。在人们心中产生信心，这是一件重要的事情。
Before we explain too much to them about Krishna and the chanting of the holy name, before we do that, first we will have to create some faith in them.
就是在我们向人们介绍或者是讲述有关 Krishna 以及唱诵圣名的有关的这个信息的时候，在这之前，我们应该在他们的心中。产生一些信心，使他们产生一些信心。
We have to explain to them that they're not the body.
我们要告诉他们，他们不是这个躯体。
You have to understand you cannot control your mind. You're not able to control your mind.
你要告诉他们，你不能够控制心意。
You're not in control of your senses.
你不能够控制你的感官。
You're the servant of the senses.
你是你感官的仆人。
We have to learn how to control the mind.
我们要学会如何控制心意。
How to control the senses.
如何控制感官。
We have to bring people to understand they're not the body.
我们首先要让人们理解他们不是这个身体。
And we have to give them some taste for chanting Hare Krishna.
我们要给他们一些唱诵 Hare Krishna 的品味。
Everyone can chant the Hare Krishna mantra.
每一个人都可以唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra.
They may not follow any principles.
也许他们并不遵守规范原则。
They're not even vegetarian.
也许他们甚至不是素食者。
But they can still chant Hare Krishna mantra.
但是即便是这样，他们也可以唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra。
And if they will chant regularly, gradually, one day they will become purified。
如果他们经常有规律的念诵的唱诵的话，终有一天他们会得到净化。
And they will give up their bad habits。
那他们就会放弃不良的习惯。
So we have to create faith in people。
所以我们要让人们。心中产生信心。
We have to do chanting, we do kirtan, sankirtan, and we give nice prasadam.
我们给予他们 kirtan, 很好听的这个 sankirtan,
By chanting the Maha Mantra and by taking Prasada, people will develop faith.
通过唱诵 Maha Mantra, 通过荣耀 Prasada, 人们呢就会得到净化，产生信心。
And then we can go on and give them more knowledge.
在此之后呢，我们就可以给予他们更多的知识。
But we don't give confidential knowledge about Krishna in the beginning.
但是我们在刚开始的时候并不会给予他们有关 Krishna 的机密的信息。
So then the tenth offense is not to have complete faith in chanting and to maintain material attachment.
第十项冒犯是对唱诵圣名没有信心，或即使明白很多有关这方面的教诲，仍维系物质的依附。
And it's also offensive to be inattentive.
不专心的念诵也是一种冒犯。
We have to chant with attention.
我们要这个专心的念诵圣名。
So if you can come to this nice temple and chant in the temple.
你们来到这个这么非常漂亮的庙宇，在这里唱诵圣名。
Or sometimes you go out walk in the park.
或者有的时候你们会出去在这个公园里散步。
What you do want to avoid is chanting, holding your mobile phone in one hand and your japa bead in the other hand.
所以无论是在哪里，你们需要避免的一个冒犯就是说，一只手拿着手机，另一只手拿着念珠。
We want to chant. We want you to concentrate on the chanting.
你们要这个在念诵的时候要专心一致。
Put aside all the other thoughts.
把所有其他的想法都放置在旁边。
And just hear the holy name.
只是聆听圣名。
So these are the ten offenses.
这是念诵圣名的十项冒犯。
Alright, so now we're going to give the beats and we'll give the name.
现在我们将这个为新起迪的奉献者给予他们名字和念珠。
It is customary at the time of initiation, we'll give another name.
这个在我们起立的时候呢，我们会给予一个名字。
Mother and father give the name for the body.
这父亲和母亲给予的是这个躯体的名字。
But the spiritual teacher will give the name for the soul.
但是呢，灵性导师会为这个灵魂赐予一个新的名字。
And the name is Das, servant of Krishna.
这个名字呢都是以 Das 结尾的，也就是 Krishna 的仆人。
We're all servants of Krishna.
我们都是 Krishna 的仆人。
But the name doesn't have any special significance.
但是这个名字呢并没有什么特殊的特别意义。
It's just to help us to become more attached to Krishna.
这个名字只是为了帮助我们更加的依附 Krishna.
Okay.So we'll give the beats now. Yeah. All right. So we'll do the ladies first.
Ladies first.
Remember?
Okay.
You got their names?
Ladies.
No, I've got.I thought I brought it to you. You got it?Vani Sujata Maniji, Mukunda Prabhu. Maybe you can introduce each of the devotees to the
Lord. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Vani Sujata Maniji is from, he is practiced from Kuching, did by the Kripa Sundar Prabhu, then he based.After 2 years back, he came to Malacca. 5 years. Yeah, he's in Malacca.
Before in Cochin?
Yeah, in Cochin, because he has been working there. Oh. The time is already...
2 years, Malacca 5 years.
Cochin 2 years, Malacca 5 years. Now in Tulungintan.
Yeah, we have ISKCON Center in Cochin. Cochin
is...
It's over the other side of Malaysia.
这个是马来西亚的另一个城市另一边
Madurai. Madurai.
Madurai is from India, Madurai.
Oh, from Madurai.
Yeah.
Oh, famous place in South India.
Yeah.
Manakshi.
Madurai. 南印度的一个非常有名的地方叫 Madurai.
ISKCON is also there in Madurai. They have two centers there. But it's a very famous place because there's the ancient deity of Meenakshi. Meenakshi, the wife of Lord Shiva. So Lord Chaitanya visited them. So Maharaji, what are the four principles? Yeah, very good. Alright. So we'll give you the name Vamsi Lila Devi Dasi. Hare Krishna. Vamsi means Krishna playing the flute.
Vamsi
is the Krishna chui the bizu. So the gopis were very fond of Krishna's. They like, you know, the flute, hearing the flute would always agitate the minds of and the gopis were envious of the flute. And they tried to steal the flute from Krishna. Because the gopis said this flute is enjoying all the nectar from the lips of Lord Krishna. And we want to enjoy that nectar. So gopis were always trying to steal the flute. But Krishna is very
much.
He's a cowherd boy. And he's always playing the flute. His flute playing attracts people all over the creation. So your name is Vamsi Lila. The next lady. Mani Meghala. Makunda, you know about Mani Meghala?
Yeah. Hare Krishna. Mani Meghala is a long time devotee, practice Krishna consciousness. Tedious, they are chanting the Hare Krishna mantra and worship Krishna. Tedious become vegetarian. Now they have a chance to take the initiation.
And she's very devoted to Lord Krishna.
Yeah.
And she's very attached. She's, Krishna is the only man in her life.
Krishna is her
life. So Maharaji, what are the four principles?
Follow the principle, the no illicit sex. Yeah, that's good. No intoxication and gambling and no meat eating.
And everyday chanting?
Yes.
Sixteen. Okay, your name Mukara Devi Dasi. Mukara. Okara is a lady, Nanda Maharaj in Vrindavan. She's one of the elderly gopi ladies. Muni Ogulya. And then another lady has
Mani Megala. Mallika.
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 Husband Wanga. Mallika Mataji is daughter, but Kalavati is the daughter. She initiated and now she stay in
Northern Highland,
and his son-in-law also, Damananda. Damananda formerly is a brahmachari in a KL center, and now is in Bhaktivedanta Manual. He did some lady worship there, and Mataji is cultivated by their own daughter and son-in-law, and engaged a lot of service in Malacca, especially sewing the lady cloth. Now the Tulsi Maharani is sold by him.
So what are the four principles?
No illicit sex, no intoxication, no meat eating, and no gambling.
Yes, and everyday chanting?
16 rounds.
Okay. So your name is Mohana Vamsi Bihari.
Mohana Vamsi Bihari. Bihari.
Bihari.
Bihari. Mohana Vamsi Bihari.
Means one who is always attracted by the flute playing of Lord Krishna. It's in the song. If you sing the song of Vibha Varishesha in the morning, there's a song by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Vibha Varishesha. So it's like that. It says, Mohana Vamsi Bihari. Yamuna Jivana Kili Parayana Manatino. Anyway, I'll find it for you in a minute. After we finish, I'll show you. It's in the songbook, the Vaishnava song. Do you have a Vaishnava songbook? Yeah. Manasat, Mohana Vamsi Bihari. Mohana means very beautiful, very attractive. Vamsi, the flute, Bihari, the beauty of that.
Yoginda Bandana Srinandana.
Number five. Yeah. Yogendra Vandana, yeah. Sri Nanda Nandana. Yogendra Vandana, Sri Nanda Nandana.
Praja Jana Baya
Hari. Praja Jana Baya Hari.
Navina
Nirada Rupa Manohara. The last line of the fifth verse. Mohana Vamsi Bihari. All right. Who's what?
B.
Vijay Mataji.
Vijay Mataji.
Vijay Mataji.
Sir, Nagin Kumar's
wife. Maybe the husband of
Maharaj.
Can
be given to
after
the initiation. Okay. Together something, you know, some ladies they take first, sometimes the husband comes later. Sometimes together.
Yeah.
The Prabhu, he is the temple president.
Yeah, temple president now. Formerly is our secretary. Then now become a president of a Krishna Balaram Center. And then did a lot of service in the temple. So just recently finished the Bhakti Sastri and everything. Very eager to get the initiation and do more service to Guru and Krishna. And his wife also always together did a lot of service in the center, especially sewing all the deity cloth and prasadam preparation and everything. And all the kids always in join with our program and everything.
Can you understand?
他是秘书，他为这个中心呢做了很多的服务，并且最近刚刚完成了这个Bhakti Sastri课程的学习，现在呢，他即将得到启迪，然后Mataji呢，也是他的妻子，然后他也在这个中心里做了很多的服务，比如说为这个神像制作新的衣服，还有准备菩萨的，也做了非常多的服务。Good,
yeah. All right, what are the four principles?
Hare Krishna Maharaj.
Yes.
No illicit sex life, no intoxication, yeah. No gambling, and no vanity.
And everyday chanting?
Then everyday chanting.
Yeah, I'm doing everyday 16
pounds.
All right. Yes.
No intoxication, no illicit sex, no gambling, no vanity.
Okay, so Prabhu's name, we give Prabhu the name Narayana Das.
Hari. Narayana Das ki.
Mataji, we give you the name Venu Gita Devi Dasi.
Hari. Venu Gita Devi
Dasi. Venu Gita.
Venu Gita Devi Dasi ki. Narayana Prabhu ki.
Venu Gita, the Gita, just like Bhagavad Gita, there's Uddhava Gita, there's Gopi Gita, this is Venu Gita.
Venu Gita.
Venu, it's a flute.
Venu is a flute.
The Gopis are attracted by the flute. The
Gopis are attracted by the flute.
And they sing the glories of the flute. So you can also remember Krishna. Okay. Okay, there's just one more man.
Another. Another. Pang Prabhu. From 2019, he's come to the temple and do chanting and everything, do a lot of service, and he just revealing Bhakti Sastri Murchindana and IDC course.
Yes, very good dedicating student.
Okay, okay. Mataji, okay.
Principles, no,
no intoxication, no drinking, no gambling.
Okay. And every day chanting?
Yes, even in the city.
How many rounds?
Actually, 25 rounds.
Oh, alright, at least 16 rounds. Okay? So, we give you the name Ananda Vardhana. One who gives pleasure to the devotees. One who gives bliss to the devotees. Ananda Vardhana. Das.
Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das. Das.